revise a few important placental abnormalities. So the first one is placenta succinturata. So here you have an accessory placental lobe which is smaller than the main lobe, and it is called as a succinturate lobe. If there is no connecting blood vessels, then it is called placenta spuria. A few of the complications are postpartum hemorrhage, subinvolution, uterine sepsis and polyformation. Placenta bilobata, both the lobes are of the same size, therefore it is called bilobata. In placenta extracorialis, what happens is you have the folding of the placental membranes onto itself, so it can be of marginate type or valate type. In marginate type, you have a very small rim, whereas in this case, you have a very thick rim. Clinical importance is increased chances of abortion, growth retardation, antepartum hemorrhage, preterm delivery, retained placenta. And finally, we have placenta membranacea, where the fetus is actually completely surrounded by the placenta. So this is called as placenta membranacea.